Right, good morning from a beautiful day in mid Norfolk. It's Peter Riley from Pharmacy Norfolk, agronomist here at Any Salmon Limited, one the best managed farms in this part of the world over the last 30 years since I've known the farm. And we're here courtesy of them. We have a fully replicated variety trial, and I'm standing in the untreated plots. Spookily, like the previous year, it started raining in this part of the world on exactly the same day, the 23rd of September, and this is a second week crop, so it wasn't drilled before that date. And so we were able to drill it, and I was here on the drilling date, and it did go in quite nicely, which is actually showing itself now. It's actually really come together really well. But this was drilled on the 24th of November, so it is quite backward, and we're starting to see disease come in now, but add 2 weeks to today, which is mid-June, you'll see a lot more disease in it. So this morning I'm going to take you down through the list of varieties, but it's going to be my personal opinion based on really the sort of parameters I look for when advising arable businesses in this part of the world. So to that end, it can be quite daunting when you look at the recommended list, but I think there's 33, 34 varieties on it. And so it's quite a lot of varieties, but it's my experience that every dog has its day, and we do have a very diverse selection of growers from Cornwall up to Scotland as such. So some of these varieties suit those parts of the world, but maybe not so much Norfolk. So what I've done is to actually put five Riley's rules as such that I would do to try and to reduce that list down to a manageable number. And the first is certainly Septoria. So really, even in this part of the world, in relatively low Septoria, we are really drilling some material still in low black grass situations, and we can get terrific Septoria. So we do need a good six, really. And really, we wouldn't entertain a variety less than six these days. And if you're in the West Country, then you might even be looking at six and a half to sevens plus. Because yes, we've had two really excellent introductions of fungicides in the last couple of years, but we've lost our best multi-site, and it can be a very challenging disease. So that's rule number one. Rule number two is that I'd like to see a variety with a decent spec weight, and there are varieties coming along that have slightly lower spec weight, so that rules out one and two. Thirdly, we must have varieties that don't lodge. Yes, we've got growth regulators, but I like to see varieties that have got a good standing rating. Fourthly, at the moment, yes, we have yellow rust that's causing some problems with some varieties. And so I'm looking at a reasonable rating on yellow rust. And finally, I believe that traits are very important. I think it's most important that when we look at varieties these days, we don't just concentrate on yield. Then we also look at traits as well. So orange wheat blossom midge is positive for me if it has it. And the last one is obviously it's got to be a competitive yield within its group of varieties. So traits are very much the way to start looking at varieties this day in modern agriculture. Okay, so we're now looking at the group one varieties we have here on the right hand side, the highest yielding KW Society, really good variety, well thought of by the millers. Sometimes we have problems getting up the protein up to the 13%, and it is getting a little bit susceptible to yellow rust, but it's got a decent septoria rating. So this is definitely one of my green list of the 14 varieties I've concentrated on. Next door to that is Skyfall, which was the most popular variety in the country. Very versatile, can be drilled late, and very versatile variety, but its breakdown to yellow rust is really significant. It's the worst variety in these plots, no problem at all. And I think in a couple of weeks time, it'd be pretty much dead. So I think this is something that we've got to say goodbye to. And then the gold standard really of milling wheat, but lower yielding, still got good yellow rust resistance, and that's Crusoe, which is the best. Most of the millers really do like Crusoe, but it's low yielding, so and it, of course, we know all about the brown rust that it gets. Okay, so now we're in the group twos, and we have really the stalwart of the group twos for the last couple of years, and relatively new pretender. And really, this relatively new pretender, KWX Days, has pretty much been taking over from that. It's got a spectacular Septoria rating, and it's got a pretty good set of features throughout. I would regard all these group twos as, if you get a group two bonus, a premium for it, it's a bonus don't really, the millers really do want Group 1. Siskin's still there, yes, losing a bit of yield. Reasonable characters can get a bit tall, but I think really X days for later drilling, mid-October drilling is suits our X sugar beet land very well. Okay, so here we have KWS Fireflow. We're now into the Group 3s. Biscuit wheat, and it's quite popular and has done reasonably well. Slightly lower spec weight, which is slightly worrying, and it is. It seems to be breaking down to brown rust and yellow rust. There is actually yellow rust in this now. It is on the AHDB's watch list as one to watch, but still a useful variety, and I think probably merits growing for another year. Okay, so we have a new Group 3 variety here. There were four new Group 3s on the list this year from Lima Grain. We've only got one of them in the trial, which is Astronomer, which is possibly, may or be I had a part of that, because I like the look of this as a candidate last year, and I like the look of it now. It's got some great features, terrific spec weight, terrific septoria rating, well over 7, and good standing. It's orange wheat blossomage. It's definitely one of those that ticks all the boxes in Riley's rules. One slight worry is if you're on the fen or you're further north and you're drilling late, you need to be a little bit concerned about the mildew, and it does get a bit of mildew in there, and it's got it in there at the moment. But other than that, this looks a really sound variety, and it's something I would very much suggest people consider growing some to have a look at. So we're now in the soft Group 4s, and these are very much two of Pharmacy Norfolk's favourites for sowing this autumn. We have LG Skyscraper on my right here. Yes, slightly lower spec weight, but a really good yielding variety. Really suits us for our October sowing. We'll do a second wheat as well, and really suits us for our later drilling after sugar beet. A nice soft wheat at the end of the day, and as good a yielding as pretty much any of the hard feeds. On my left, a new candidate from last year, but fully recommended now, RGT Sakif, and from RAGT. Different type of variety, complements the Skyscraper very well, can be drilled a little bit earlier. Got to be careful a little bit of the lodging, but other than that, it's not got any real problems to it, apart from slightly later harvest. So it really does complement the Skyscraper, and again, you get a barn full of soft wheat. So these two varieties are very much Pharmacy Norfolk favourites. Okay, so we're now into some hard feeds, and we have SY Inciter on the right-hand side. A high yielding variety, a bit tall, getting a little bit of yellow rust in it, so questionable whether that's adding anything to some of the other varieties. On my left hand side, come back in a fortnight's time, this will be yellow. This is Kinetic, and you can see there's quite a bit of yellow rust. It's unfortunate, because outside of the yellow rust, this is a really nice variety. And then really a stalwart of this part of the world for early drilling next door to that, which is Gleam. Really the variety that's pretty much first on everyone's list. It's very versatile, a good reasonable septoria score and good yield, and a pretty versatile variety. Now it's getting a little bit more yellow rust, so do be careful of that, but it certainly could be a possibility for another year. Okay, so here we have Graham on my right. It's a great survivor, really. It's been around for some time. And it's pretty good at everything, really. I mean, it's a different parentage than many of the other varieties, but it still has good septoria, good yellow rust, and it's pretty reliable year in, year out. It still hangs around. Maybe not the out-and-out yield, but it's still there. So we've got a newly recommended variety here, KWS Cranium. We had a seed crop over the other side of the road here last year, and it really did well after a late sown crop. And that's where I think it really suits. It's out of Crispin, which in this part of the world used to do really well, later drilled on light soil. And this is, it's given this variety pretty much the same attributes. Has a little bit of mildew in it, has only just got good enough spec weight. It's got a reasonable septoria rate, but it's got out and out yield for later sowing. So it is a hard wheat, a hard feed wheat, but if you want something that's really going to yield for slightly later sowings, a very good choice. Right, and here we have RGT Wolverine, a really exciting new development within breeding. As you'll be aware, it has BYD resistance. So that's a really good attribute. If you're trying to grow wheat in mid-September down in Devon or something like that, this is your boy, because it is resistant. Still might have to do something with insecticides, but it's still a very good variety from that point of view. Its traits other than that lead a little bit to be desired. It can get a little bit of yellow rust. It does get a bit of septoria. So it's a matter of whether you're trading against that wonderful BYDV trait against some of the other traits that the variety has. But a really good introduction, and we look forward to further introductions in the future. Okay, so we're in the candidates. So I'm only going to pick out two because we haven't got them all here. Maybe talk about Palladium as well, which is a group one. Palladium looks very good on all features, with the exception of protein, and that might be a real problem to it in the future. But this is RGT Besto from RAGT, and they've clearly got a cricket fan within their marketing department. And it looks a really useful soft feed wheat. Early days, but it's got some pretty good characters throughout and a reasonable amount of yield. So looks a useful variety to me at the moment, but it's early days. Here is the other candidate that I'm going to look at. This is Champion from DSV. So it's a nice variety from that seed house. It's the highest yielding feed around, so it's got a lot of good traits to it. The one trait I'd be worried about at this stage is that the declared spec weight is 75. That's just a little low for me. Other than that, it looks a really nice variety. So that's a quick run through some of the varieties we have here. I'm sorry if I've not mentioned one or two of the varieties that don't appear on my sort of shortened list. They're still very decent varieties, but I think I've highlighted the ones that I particularly like. All the data, of course, is in the AHDB variety booklet, which is the first place to look at for all the data. And I'll highlight a couple of things in there. One is that the yellow rust and brown rust is ringed now, because you need to take those with suspicion. And also follow that up by looking up the watch list, the AHDB watch list, because that's giving you a bit of a risk of where these varieties might go. It's a very useful feature. And then one final feature that I think all growers and agronomists should have on their phones is the RL app. It's a very useful app, which is very straightforward to use. And whilst you're in the field, you can actually pick out all the details that you want on that particular variety, and actually write a note if you're going through any variety trials. So do have a look at your app supplier and look up RL app. It's a really useful piece of work.